Abend, meine sehr verehrten Damen und Herren. Heute wollen wir uns eine brisante Aussage von Jimmy Carter genauer ansehen. Jimmy Carter war der 39. US-Präsident, also keine unbedeutende Persönlichkeit. Und zwar geht es um die USA und das Initiieren von Kriegen. Jimmy Carter sagte gegenüber Journalisten, dass die Welt die USA für den größten Kriegsentfessler hält. Ihm zufolge meinen die Menschen, dass US-Amerikaner zu jedem Anlass Konflikte initiieren. Carter erinnerte im Interview an die Rede des US-Außenministers John Kerry, der behauptete, dass man im 21. Jahrhundert nicht so einfach in ein fremdes Land eindringen kann. Der Reporter kommandierte, dass dies genauso klinge wie der US-Kriegseinsatz im Irak. Hierauf antwortete Carter, genau das haben wir getan und wir tun es heute noch. So ist Washington nun mal. Leider. Wenn man sich die letzten Kriege ansieht, so kann diese Aussage sehr wohl bestätigt werden. Jetzt im Ukraine-Konflikt gilt es auch genau zu beobachten, ob nicht wieder US-Kriegstreiber dahinter stecken. Bleiben Sie daher wachsam und verfolgen Sie den Verlauf genau. Klagemauer TV hilft Ihnen, hinter die Kulissen zu blicken. Auf Wiedersehen.
Schön, dass Sie wieder zugeschaltet haben auf Klagemauer TV. Heute berichten wir über Ostern. Ostern à la Obama. Guten Abend. An Ostern 2014 wurden im Jemen während 3 Tagen wiederholt US-Drohnenangriffe auf vermutete Aufenthaltsorte von Top-Terroristen geflogen. Dabei wurden mittels Luft-Boden-Raketen rund 40 Menschen ermordet. Die meisten Toten sind unbeteiligte, unschuldige Menschen. Ob überhaupt eins der anvisierten sogenannten hochrangigen Ziele getroffen wurde, blieb unklar. Zur selben Zeit, als dort die Raketen explodierten, erklärte Barack Obama in seiner wöchentlichen Radioansprache in Washington D.C., dass er mit seiner Familie die Ostermesse besuchen wolle, um unter anderem die Hoffnung von Ostern zu feiern. Diese offensichtliche Doppelmoral enthüllt den US-Präsidenten trotz Friedensnobelpreis als Handlanger für kriegerische Aktionen unter dem Deckmantel eines Friedensapostels. Passend dazu hatte schon Platon gesagt, die äußerste Ungerechtigkeit ist die, welche unter dem Schein des Rechts begangen wird. Damit verabschieden wir uns von Ihnen und wünschen einen guten Abend.
My expertise, as you know, is CIA, Marine Corps, 3 CIA secret wars. I had a position in the National Security Council in 1975 as the chief of the Angola task force running the secret war in Angola. It was the 3rd CIA secret war I was part of. The National Security Law creating the National Security Council and the CIA, as you know, was passed in 1947. The CIA was given this charter to perform such other duties and function as might be necessary to the national security interests, and given a vague authority to protect its sources and methods. I think it was in the mid-80s that I coined this phrase, the Third World War, because in my research I realized that we were not attacking the Soviet Union and the CIA's activities, we were attacking people in the Third World. And I'm going to just quickly, in the interest of time, just give you a little sense of what that means, this Third World War. Basically, it's the third, I believe, in terms of loss of life and human destruction, the third bloodiest war in all of history. They undertake to run operations in every corner of the globe. They also undertook the license of operating just totally above and beyond U.S. laws. They had a license, if you will, to kill, but also they took that to a license to smuggle drugs, a license to do all kinds of things to other people in other societies in violation of international law, our law, and every principle of nations working together for a healthier and more peaceful world. Meanwhile, again, they battled to convert the U.S. legal system in such a way that it would give them control of our society. Now, we have massive documentation of what they call the secret wars of the CIA. We don't have to guess or speculate. We had the Church Committee investigate them in 1975, gave us our first really in-depth, powerful look inside this structure. Senator Church said in the 14 years before he did his investigation that he found they had run 900 major operations and 3,000 minor operations. And if you extrapolate that over the whole period of the 40-odd years that we've had a CIA, you come up with 3,000 major operations and over 10,000 minor operations. Every one of them illegal, every one of them disruptive of the lives and societies of other peoples, and many of them bloody and gory beyond comprehension almost. Extensively, we manipulated and organized the overthrow of functioning constitutional democracies in other countries. We organized secret armies and directed them to fight in just about every continent in the world. We encouraged ethnic minorities to rise up and fight. People like the Mosquito Indians in Nicaragua, the Kurds in the Middle East, the Hmongs in Southeast Asia. And of course, we have organized and we still do and fund death squads in countries around the world, like the Treasury Police in El Salvador, which are responsible for most of the killing of the 50,000 people just in the 80s, and there were 70,000 before that. And orchestration, CIA secret teams, and propaganda led us directly into the Korean War. We were attacking China from the islands, Kaimoi, Matsu, Thailand, Tibet. A lot of drug trafficking involved in this, by the way, until eventually we convinced ourselves to fight the Chinese and Korean. We had the Korean War and 1 million people were killed. Same thing for the Vietnam War, and we have extensive documentation of how the CIA was involved at every level, or the national security complex, because it's a very cooperative thing, into manipulating the nation into the Vietnam War. And we wound up creating the Golden Triangle, in which the CIA, Air America airplanes, were flying in arms to our allies and flying back out with the heroin. We launched the largest, this is something that Jimmy Carter did, Admiral Turner brags about it, the operation in Afghanistan. Biggest single operation, I'm told, in the history of the CIA's secret wars. And sure enough, very quickly we produced the Golden Crescent, which is still the largest source of heroin perhaps in the world today. Trying to summarize this third world war that the CIA, the U.S. National Security Complex, with the military all interwoven in it in many different ways, has been waging. Let me just put it this way. The best heads that I coordinate with studying this thing, we count at least minimum figure 6 million people who've been killed in this long 40-year war that we've waged against the people of the third world. These are not Soviets. We have not been parachuting teams into the Soviet Union to kill and hurt and maim people, especially not since 1954, when they developed actually a capability of dropping atomic weapons on the United States. They aren't British, French, Swedes, Swiss, Belgians. We don't do bloody, gory operations in the countries of Europe. These are all people of the third world. They're people of countries like the Congo, Vietnam, Kampuchea, Indonesia, Nicaragua, where conspicuously they nor their governments do not have the capability of doing any physical hurt to the United States. They don't have ICBMs, they don't have armies or navies. They could not hurt us if they wanted to. There has rarely been any evidence that they really wanted to. And that, in fact, is perhaps the whole point. If they had had ICBMs, we probably wouldn't have done the things to them for fear of retaliation. Cheap shots, if you will, killing people of other countries of the world who cannot defend themselves under the guise of secrecy and under the rubric of national security.
Haben auch Sie ein öffentliches Unrecht zu beklagen oder von einem Sieg zu berichten? Bleiben Sie damit nicht allein. Schreiben Sie noch heute an klagemauer.tv.
Klagemauer TV. Nicht gläserne Bürger, gläserne Medien, Politiker und Finanzmogule brauchen wir.